have shown us, when you do this,
yeah.
What is the
this one for? Okay.
This the check what for?
Oh, from here. This one.
Yes, here. Yeah. For an application in practice.
Okay. If Kevin punch me, he's strong. I put the energy.
Este es llevando la energía, recibiendo la energía.
Yeah.
It's like we're seeing, like
you see. But
the other hand, the other hand is controlling.
Control the any punch, then you sing. Mm. Yeah, it's a catch. Okay, let me. Will you punch me? Yeah, okay, so you punch. Punch your arm. Is it? Okay, yeah, to catch the main technique, but that's one technique you can use it to catch the arm.
Catch. Yeah.
Otra pregunta. Venga.
I guess we know everything.
Yeah.
It's really funny. When the person goes away, the teacher goes away, everyone goes, guess what? I want to ask that question. I forgot to ask him that question.
Cuando él se va, todo el mundo va a pensar, ah, había esta pregunta. Como acaba de decir, él se va en media hora. Y vosotros probablemente no vais a verle hasta que, bueno, 6 meses o un año. Así que ahora es el momento de hacer preguntas.
I have another question.
Yeah.
In the box hall,
yeah.
For the fans, can you show us more applications of
box
hall?
Okay. Yes. If the person punches you this area here, you can use box hall too. Box hall means wing arm.
Wing arm. Box significa brazo de ala.
Yeah, so if you put me here, come on, bongs over here. Now, say I'm in close with him, I can also use bongs over here internally.
También puedes utilizarlo desde un punto de contacto.
And then look, so bongs over here to go forward.
El bong para ir para adelante.
If you punch me, bongs over here directly.
El bong para guiar la energía.
Many situations. Yeah? Mm-hmm. That's bongs over, many situations. He might punch me, I'll come here, and I'll do this one. Bongs over.
El bong para romper.
To break his arm. As we call bongs out, low bongs out. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, or bongs out, if people have gone here and gone backwards, yeah, bongs out, do we.
Bong, pero in rewind, no?
Yeah, rewind.
Para llevar el brazo.
And after bongs out, what do you do after?
Other bongs out, first.
Depends.
The bongs out must be spot on. Second, you can know what's coming next.
Primero el bongs out tiene que ser 100%. Después,
like he might punch me here, then I might do this. He might punch me here, I might do this. He might punch me here, I might do this. He might punch me here, I might step away and go again and do this.
Nunca sabemos lo que vamos a hacer hasta que el otro presenta el brazo.
Wing Chun not like set, right? You must do this. No,
el Wing Chun no está en una forma fija, tienes que cambiar la situación. No? So, however he presents his arm to you, you'll react to it.
You react to it, yes.
You can't know.
You can't say, it might be Pacific here. The punch might be a bit higher, it might be here. Might be higher, it might be here.
Mm.
It'd be higher, but without bongs out here now.
No.
No.
For the bong drill though, you enter with the
no. If I do bongs out here, and he punched me, I took it. If I do bongs over here and he punched me, I've gone forward. If I do bongs over here, bongs might come again and go here. If I bongs over here, you know, and he punched me, I do it and go forward, and he's not here and go here.
I remember you saying though that only use the bongs if you know it very well.
Yes.
Because it's a very hard thing
it's
to get right.
To use.
Él dijo alguna vez que solo utilizamos el bounce out si lo sabemos muy bien, porque es un movimiento muy difícil de hacer bien.
In fact,
si no lo sabemos muy bien, mejor que no lo tocamos.
In fact, I use all the techniques you know very well.
Sí, en realidad solo debemos
utilizar
las técnicas que sabemos muy bien.
Yeah.
Y dejamos lo demás por un lado de momento.
Know the technique very well, and you can use all the techniques. but you don't detect the variable regardless of bonsal, pusal, jumsal, yunsal. If you can't use it or don't know it very well, you can't use it.
Yeah.
So we say you learn everything really well.
Yeah, hay que aprender todo muy bien para poder utilizar cualquier acción desde cualquier situación.
Yeah, because sometimes people say bonsal, bonsal, you can recognize Wingchun from the bonsal.
Mm.
But maybe I don't need bonsal to use, I use something else.
Tal vez no le hace falta utilizar este bonsal cuando está luchando. Mucha gente no lo ven como una forma de Wing Chun, ¿no? Y fijan en esto como, bueno, esto es el Wing Chun, pero no hace falta muchas veces utilizarlo.
Okay.
Mm.
How to react against an attack with the elbow?
With the elbow? First you must understand.
¿Cómo debemos reaccionar contra un ataque con el codo?
If the elbow comes, don't beat it. That's one way.
Don't beat it.
Disappear.
Si tienes el codo, que no estés. No estés en la primera opción.
And if the elbow comes, you know how to catch it with technique. You can catch it.
Si viene el codo, debemos. Si sabemos la manera de pillarlo en moción, podemos pillarlo.
So anything you learn, you say, can you catch it? Can you stop it? Or can you move away from it?
Cualquier cosa que aprendemos, hay que preguntar si podemos coger o pillarlo, guiarlo o mover fuera de ello.
Example, he attacks my throat.
Por ejemplo, él ataca a la cara.
Yeah, take my throat and locks me, that's it, choke me. So, how do you stop someone taking your throat? Take my throat, don't let him touch you, that's it. Grab my throat again, touch my throat,
that's it. No permitimos que la persona aplica esta técnica. Esta es la primera manera de salvarnos de esto.
But maybe, I tell you, I'll come, don't touch your throat. Yeah? Yeah? And we start, don't even touch your throat. See this now? Yeah? So don't even touch your throat, and if we know, I don't want to touch your throat.
Someone's touching your throat.
So, you have to practice.
Así que hay que practicar.
When two persons are, ¿cómo se dice? Cogidos los dos, o con las manos,
like grappling.
Yes, a little bit grappled, all together.
Locked.
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah.
How feel the head?
If someone, this is sticky, that means that if someone comes towards me and he grabs me,
what I do,
I stick to him. Everything.
With the head
also. If I've done this now, he can headbutt me and push me, and he can also bite me. What's happening? Both of us can bite each other. Yeah? But when you go close to the head, then you can't get the teeth on the arm. Yeah? But if the head is free, he can bite.
Yeah.
So this is sticky.
El concepto es pegarse al oponente con todo, con la cabeza, con todo, para que el otro no puede morder.
You were right about the head, you should be right about the teeth. Yeah?
Sí,
de
los dientes.
So, you check everything, put your head down, you check everything so I can't move the head to bite him. But take your head away, cow. This is what I mean by when you fight someone on the street, real fighting on the street, he can use anything. His fingers,
cuando
his teeth, his headbutt.
En realidad, en la calle, la persona puede utilizar cualquier cosa.
You can't do this in competition. You can't bite someone in competition.
No se puede.
We say, unless you're Tyson. Unless you're Tyson.
Tal vez el Mike Tyson, sí.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Si la persona es muy rápido, como un tipo de boxeador, ¿qué podemos hacer para ello?
You have to practice reaction, speed, and someone hitting you.
Hay que practicar la reacción, la velocidad y alguien tirando con velocidad hacia nosotros.
The only way you can overcome it is by practicing it.
La única manera de
It Calvin hits me here quickly, really here quickly.
Hacerlo es
Even quick, and I can't stop him. I have to. I've got to plug in. I might get hit for 6 months. I might get hit for 1 week. I might get hit only one day. And he goes again, and I catch him. And I go, and I catch him. And I catch him. But the practice, when I first started, maybe he hit me a lot. When? Then hit me a lot. And later on, I'll catch it. That's how you practice.
Okay.
Yes? So sometimes you have to get touch.
A veces,
to learn something to
muchas veces hay que comer, hay que recibir bastante para aprender. Tenemos que no pensar desde el punto de vista que no queremos que alguien nos toca. Hay que ponerlo como un reto, ¿no? Y más adelante vamos a poder cerrar este hueco. Pero hay que recibir para poder practicarlo.
I don't know if someone have a knife. The same techniques of Wing Chun can be able to disarm or defend yourself.
Si alguien tiene un cuchillo, si podemos utilizar las mismas técnicas de Wing Chun en esta situación.
Okay. Now this, when you have a knife, when we do Wing Chun first, you practice Wing Chun by your hands. So have trust your arms first. Now. Some people say they will learn weaponry first. If you can't control the arm, you can't control the weapon.
Hay gente que dicen que quieren empezar con la arma, ¿no? Si no podemos controlar la arma, si no podemos controlar los brazos, no vamos a poder controlar las armas.
Unless you go to a pure knife school, it does pure knife fighting, and then they will learn that.
Bueno, si vamos a una escuela de pura que solo hacen técnicas de cuchillo. Tal vez podemos aprenderlo.
Now, when someone brings a knife at you, there's a beginning, middle, and an end.
Cuando alguien saca un cuchillo hacia nosotros, hay un principio, un mitad.
Calvin might be here and put a knife at me.
Tal vez él va a sacar el cuchillo.
Present the knife at me. And I'm scared. I am scared.
Ahora tiene miedo, ¿no?
I am scared to do a technique. I'm scared of everything. I'm scared to get stabbed. I lost already.
Si le preocupa mucho de la situación de recibir de que él le corta, ya ha perdido.
Doesn't matter how much martial arts you know, you become scared when the knife came out.
No importa la cantidad de artes marciales que sabemos, si entramos con miedo cuando sale el cuchillo, vamos a tener. Vamos
But
a perder.
If he presents the knife to me, and he might try to pierce me, whatever. I might to kick him here, the low section. You know?
Ataca hacia abajo.
He might pierce me, I'm so quickly. I've got a trusted technique, because he's clearly watching. What I've done,
técnica.
I hit the throat, so he can feel the pain here, so he can drop the knife. I don't hit the body. If I go and hit the body, he can stab me, and he can also cut me on the way out.
Bajo el cuello.
Yeah.
Para que él deje el cuchillo rápidamente. No va al cuerpo, porque si va al cuerpo, el otro también puede pinchar, ¿no?
So, if you want to learn knife fighting, you've got to learn how to overcome the knife, the fear, the techniques, everything at one time. Yeah? You can't just say you're going to defend someone with a knife and you can do it. Yeah? You might get a shock.
Yeah.
So, therefore, what you've got to do is try to practice with each other, have a little small knife first, more than one.
Hay que practicar con un cuchillo de madera al inicio para aprender las posibilidades y estudiar un poco lo que podemos hacer.
And then you have another knife with a silver one, like a shiny, like a blade.
Después algo más parecido a un cuchillo de verdad.
And then you can go for a real knife.
Y después puedes ir por el cuchillo real.
But basically you go for the silver one
first,
you see, it's a mindset. So when you see a silver, you see a knife. It shines.
Hay que ir por el cuchillo de plata primero antes del cuchillo real para notarlo, para ver cómo. cómo se brilla para reaccionar, ¿no? A algo real.
And then you see, well, in a situation, if the person comes so close towards you and you hear someone's face and talk to him, yeah, yeah, well, he can do this and stab you. Because it's quite dangerous, he can stab you like that.
Si la persona es muy cerca,
because you stand so close and you should always stand here. So
siempre hay que tener una distancia entre tú y el adversario.
So if it comes to present at night, you've got a chance to do something.
Para tener una posibilidad de hacer algo.
But you go somewhere like, yeah, what are you saying? You say he can stand just like that.
Gives you a little bit of time, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So in the moment that he's coming to you,
yes,
and he's not really, you just step back or
step back? Up to you. Okay. It's up to you. Now, he might come towards me, yeah, and I might step back because he's trying to cross me and step back. And he might come again and I might have to kick him up, took up. I might kick him or do something else. Now, he might rush towards me and I might step and go ahead. Yeah, and do a different technique. Yeah? Yeah. Now, because he's got a knife, I think in his eyes, so he can't see that much.
Algo grave requiere algo, una reacción de la misma nivel, ¿no? De
calidad. Because if I hit his body, maybe he can still cut me.
Si él le da en el cuerpo, tal vez pueda aguantarlo y aún pinchar.
But if I hit in his eyes, and cough out, and for the shock, the pain, getting in your eyes,
si
he le, might drop the knife
si
and
si
go do
that. Si le en el ojo, probablemente va a dejar el cuchillo.
Knife coming up.
What's that?
When you attack before the night.
Yes. Now, it depends. Watch carefully. Usually, I don't come so close towards you. So, if you brought a knife out, it'd be coming up from there. I would never let you, I would never be here.
Normalmente, él no se acerca a la persona en este momento porque quiere dejar un poco de espacio. Y va a notar el cuchillo saliendo aquí.
But if I'm close towards you now,
si está muy cerca,
and your arm is here, and I'm close to talk to you, and you put your hand in your pocket, then I'll just hit you.
Yeah.
Yes. Because you put your hand, yeah, for a reason. Yeah. But if it's now different.
Si pone la mano en el bolsillo para cualquier movimiento o razón, tiene que pegarle.
Different scenarios.
Es un escenario distinto.
You've got a couple more.
You've got a couple more, then. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So different scenarios. Then another scenario is maybe you're in a nightclub or somewhere and the people come with your weapon, or if you go back to your wall.
Si estás en una discoteca y alguien viene con un cuchillo, lo mejor es poner la espalda hacia el pared.
Always find a way quickly, because someone can't get behind you and stab you.
Así ninguno puede ponerse detrás de ti y
so you have to sometimes think ahead really quickly.
Así que hay que espabiarse rápidamente.
But if you stay in the middle, maybe you've got a friend there, friendly, and they'll just put my stab you.
Yeah.
So you have to quickly. Well, at least you know someone comes towards you, you can see them coming towards you, no one comes towards you.
Por lo menos puedes ver la persona yendo hacia aquí, desde el pared, y cubrir la espalda.
All depends on the scenario.
Todo depende de la situación.
What do you have for a punch like this, front or low punch here?
Yeah. Do you do it when comes here?
Yeah.
It comes.
Come on. Punching.
Here,
I'm
front.
Okay.
And low.
The idea is, don't get touched, block, but you must know how to block. Now, if the punch can come from anywhere, I might be standing and if you come in and you can punch me here.
Situation.
Yeah? The punch can be coming from here and you can punch me here. The idea is, I don't know where the punch is going to come from. You got to know how to stop it where it comes from.
Hay que saber cómo podemos pararlo.
Yeah. If you told me, how do you do a punch from here? I said, show me, because I know many punch from here. So you show me what you mean.
Show what?
Show me.
What kind of punch?
Yeah.
This punch.
Okay, now.
I wonder how to
do it.
Defend.
Yeah.
He's asking how to defend, not how to do the punch.
No, how to defend it. But what? It's the beginning, middle, and the end. So, what's your beginning?
Es tu principio. Hay el principio, el medio y el final. El principio es.
Haz el puño.
Haz el puño.
No entiendo.
The
beginning. The beginning. Here. Here is the beginning.
Okay, well, punch me here. No, okay.
Ah, okay.
Punch me here.
Yeah,
Daigo, walk an upper from the close to the kind of angle here.
Okay, now.
If you're close.
Okay, what's good?
Yes,
if you're close. No, remember I said to you.
That's quite a hard one to.
No, remember I said to you. and then they will get close to me.
So, okay.
So the first rule.
No, la primera regla es que no dejamos que el otro se
acerque. I don't know. It's like, yeah. What? And you go. Yeah, you can send me whatever. I keep this tool as well.
Se mantiene la
distancia. Then, for example, in sticky.
Yes.
Then you are sticky and here.
Okay. Now sticky is technical. It's technical aspect.
Yeah. So esto cuando tenemos los brazos en contacto es un aspecto más.
Yeah. I want to know more technical.
Okay. Now the idea is if you stop this one, then you can learn about stopping this one.
Yeah.
Then you can learn about stopping this one. Then you can learn about stopping this one and this one and this one and this one. Take one at a time.
Yeah.
Okay. This one.
Hay que ir poco a poco porque si. Si quieres parar esta, tienes que saber cómo paramos todos.
Because
no, es el mismo concepto.
Because I'm going to do this one.
Mm.
I'm going to do this one.
Yeah.
And you're stuck now. Yeah. Because your mind was only fixed on this one.
On that one.
And I didn't do it. Yeah. I done this one or this one.
Yeah.
So don't get fixed on the
no,
technique.
No fijamos en una técnica específica, sino tenemos que practicar todos.
If you're in a situation. An example, we're practicing, and you were in a situation here, and I said to you, the technique, put me from here, that's the technique. Mm-hmm. You're in a situation.
Mm-hmm.
Then I send you another situation here, hook up, then palm straight, different situation. Then another situation here, come and punch me, I've gone here. Different situation.
Mm-hmm.
So the all situations are different, yeah. Regardless, you're going to hook.
Todas las situaciones son distintas. Todo depende de la posición.
So, usually people ask about the technique. What would happen if someone does this? What would happen if someone does this? That's
I want to know more types of way to stop it.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Like, for example, a punch like this,
yes.
You can stop it like here,
yeah.
Like that,
yeah.
Then here.
Okay.
I want to know technique aspects.
You will learn it in time. You can't learn everything at one time. So, good question, but you can't learn everything at one time.
Yeah.
Learn bit by bit.
Time.
One more question? One more question, there we go. He dropped his energy down, and then he hit me down. That means he dropped the energy down. That means I pushed
him. El baja la energía.
And he said,
"Push." Y abra una línea.
But now he might be on the bottom and go up.
Puede ser abajo y sube.
Yes. So this is all different situations and situations. Yeah? So when you see people do it here and here, some people do it here and here, some people do it here and here. You must understand. Do you know how to apply? And do you understand?
I guess I can. Hay que pensar si sabemos cómo podemos aplicarlo.
Yeah, so
I remember on the grab you can sometimes use it as well to break the grip, like the.
No, it won't. It won't. No.
Right.
If I grab you, you grab me.
Too late.
And you grab me.
Yeah.
You're back. That's what I meant.
Yeah.
Now before you put pressure on me, what I'm going to do? I'm going to punch you.
Yeah.
But you push pressure on me, and I can't.
Yeah.
And I can't punch you because you push it here.
Yeah.
But you touch me, I put pressure up and release and punch you. You see? Now you see why, when we go to here, we go to here.
Yeah.
So you
that's
see?
The lock.
The lock. So you can't find them here. But back on softly when you're like this way. Just punch me.
Just
quick punch. You see? So you see?
When someone grabs you.
Probably
from
behind. Yeah, from the back. Yeah, from the back. Okay, this is all good. You have a circle around here. Is this diagram a circle?
In the diagram, there's a circle.
You must know what's behind at all times.
I guess I will not decide to ask the key.
Yeah. So I know there's one person here. I know there's two on the head. I know. Yeah, I know.
It's like constantly the los alrededores.
But if I feel you coming towards me, come behind.
Same nota, okay, I think it's
the end of the line. Then you see here. Then you see here. because I can't prove. Now, if I can't prove you do nothing at all.
Yeah.
You want me here, I can turn you this way and escape. I can turn you this way and here.
Yeah,
I can turn you this way and go here later. So in this situation, I can be here and go here on your toes.
Yeah.
I can also turn you this way. And also, before you get there, I can feel you come towards me, I'm going here. Then grab, grab. See, here. And then also, you might come towards me, so I'm going here, pick you. In this situation, so if you're aware someone's behind you, you can react to something. But you're not aware.
It's not the reality inside the past, the deep, and it's right now.
It's like, if you...
I can't start then.
So if I'm in the room and I see all these people here in front of me, and these guys try to sneak behind me, I see trying to sneak behind me, I just did this. Yeah? You see? I said, oh, yeah. Then I said, you try to sneak behind me. Now do this. Yeah? Now just do this. And then I'll do this. Come now. You put yourself in a situation so you don't get hurt. Awareness of the situation. Anyway, like I said, the idea of the workshop is to open your mind.
La idea de este workshop es para abrir un poco la mente, ¿no? Nuestros.
So you understand what you're doing. You felt what it's like to do it.
Conocer bien lo que estamos haciendo y sentir lo que es.
And you realize that to do something, especially feel it, to know what it's like to appreciate.
Y también, bueno, hemos notado cómo es la sensación y hemos notado cómo es hacerlo de verdad.
And it's also good to sort of ask it as a question: what will happen if that? What this will happen? What will happen if you do this?
Está bien tirar preguntas que puede pasar si pasa esto, ¿no? Situaciones.
You got an idea, but the most important thing is to practice.
Lo más importante es practicar.
That's the most important thing.
La palabra clave es practicar.
And practice in harmony with each other.
Y practica correspondiendo con el compañero.
And look at the structure, very, very important.
Y fijaos en la estructura.
If you have no structure, you can't do nothing.
Si no tenemos una estructura, no podemos hacer nada.
So you can practice for many, many years, and your structure is poor. And if it works against someone, because the other person is also poorer than you, that's all great.
Si practicamos durante muchos años y tenemos una estructura flojillo, tal vez es por la suerte que el otro no sabe mucho, ¿no? Y eso, esto es.
But I hope that you can remember some of the techniques, I hope you can practice some of the techniques, and I hope you can remember the structure. If I will come again in the future, whatever, and your structure is really good, I can give you more and more techniques.
Espero que podemos recordar las técnicas y practicarlas, y si viene en el futuro y hemos mantenido estas técnicas, tal vez nos va a dejar más.
But you have to practice.
Pero hay que practicar.
So I'd like to thank David and me here.
Que dar las gracias a mí por llevarles aquí.
And all you guys for attending.
Y a nosotros por estar.
Thank Gil and Calvin for assisting me.
El Calvin por asistir.
In fact, my Lord, I'd love to get me here safely and get the back home safely.
Gracias a Allah por llevarle aquí y a casa.
Get back home safely, inshallah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the most important thing. But the idea we have fun, we enjoyed ourselves, it's good.
La hemos pasado bien y esto es lo que es lo importante.
Thanks again.
Bueno, thank you.